Hi, my name's Adrian James from Nice Times Close. You're watching Live Prog.
I jumped on the big, big train in 2007 when the band released their album The Difference Machine. And I must say, I was very impressed by this album and I enjoyed the ride so much, I decided to stay on and see where it would bring me. It would bring me past some very interesting stops, most notably 2009 when the band released The Underfall Yard. Now, this album had definitely helped Big Big Train to enter the major league of progressive rock. A fantastic album, but it also raised the bar for them. Of course, the ride didn't end there. The train kept on going, passing a few other stations. At one such station, I would very much like to stop for a moment, because that station is this one, English Electric Part 1.
Where streams like giants' fingers close from the hills to the emptiness beneath, to the depths of the mirror. Morning light, midwinter sun, underneath the river sun.
If there's one thing I have learned from traveling along the Big Big Train, is the fact that they are incredible storytellers. Just look up the lyrics to all the past couple of albums, The Underfall Yard, The Far Skies Deep Time EP, but of course also this one, English Electric, Part 1. Here we have it. Now it's really beautiful, luxurious digipack with, of course, the CD in it. No, it's very, well, what kind of stories do you find on this album? Different kinds of stories. Stories about people, about humble people, people who played their part, and whether or not they are fictional or actual persons, I don't know, I leave that in the middle. It doesn't matter for the story. It's very interesting to enjoy those stories. Take for example Alexander Lambert, a diver, trying out some sort of experimental aid to go underwater. Or the story of Tom Keating, an art forger. But not just about people, also about the landscapes, you know, the beautiful countryside, the amazing things you find in England. From the moment I heard this track, the first rebreather, I gotta say I was really overwhelmed. It is such a beautiful and mesmerizing track that really says wow, you know, it's absolutely stunning. And I gotta tell you, when I was listening to that track, it fits, you know, everything just is perfect in that track. You gotta understand one thing, that kind of level, that really overwhelming, that wow level, is kept on throughout the whole album, you know, from beginning to end. I mentioned the singer, and I gotta honestly say, you know, of course, if you read the lyrics and if you listen to the music, it's beautiful, but David Longden just adds a little sparkle to those tracks. He's a very gifted singer, and I gotta say, not just on this album, but especially on this album, his vocals are an absolute highlight for me throughout the whole album. Are really full of flavor. They are rich, just like you find in the English countryside, which is also really beautiful, and there are a lot of sights to see. I mentioned the singer who brings life to those stories, but of course the singer is nothing without the musicians. There are some really talented people driving this big, big train. We have, of course, the founding members, the heartbeat of Big Big Train, Greg Spaughton and Andy Poole. And if you look at the album, if you look at the track listing and see what they do, they basically play whatever instrument is necessary for that particular song. Add to that Mr. Nick DeVirgilio. We know him, of course, from Spock's Beard. He is an amazing drummer, and again, that is evident on this album. Another very fine musician that has also become a full member of the band is Mr. Dave Gregory. You also might know him from the band Ecstasy. And of course, David Longden as lead vocalist. But not just the lead vocalist. He does more than just singing. He also plays, I would say, an assortment of small instruments. Well, small. He also plays some keyboards. One of the things he plays is the flute. Now, if you know me, you know that I think that is a beautiful atmosphere maker in an album. And it works fantastic on this one. So I'm really happy again. He does different instruments as well. For example, listen to the track Uncle Jack. And there he plays some banjo, some tambourine and other instruments that give it a nice folky touch. And that is what I like about this album. It's progressive rock, it's melodic, but it also has the flavor of the countryside in the music. And that makes it stand out, I think, above pretty much everything else. Add to that a little more, because there are more musicians involved in this really beautiful album. There are a couple of guest musicians, but one of them truly stands out. We all know him, Mr. Andy Tellison from The Tangent. Just listen to his fabulous organ part in Judas Unrepentant. You know, fabulous track, and well, you hear it is his style, but again, it fits so perfectly on this album. And listen well, and you hear his remarkable play on a couple of other tracks as well. Hey, Judas Unrepentant. Hey, Judas. This album, I must say, I am very much impressed by the superb level of musicianship you find on this one. From beginning to end, it sounds impeccable, you know, absolutely stunning. I've been listening to the album quite a bit. As you know, I do it in all sorts of ways. Well, a couple of days ago, I was preparing for this review and I decided, you know, I'm gonna put on my headphones and listen to it. And wow, I was completely lost. I forgot everything around me. And at a certain point, you know, I was busy preparing. I figured, you know, what is this beautiful song that I am listening to? And I got a check, and it was The Winchester from St. Giles Hill. And I thought, wow, what a stunning track. And especially when you listen to headphones, you know, you're closed off from everything around you. And then you hear how beautiful this album is, because it's not just that song, of course. It, as I mentioned, the high level is carried out throughout the whole album. Listening to this album, I can be honest and I say there is not a weak song on the album. There's not even a weak moment on this album. It is a high level of quality, high level of amazing compositions, excellent production from beginning to end. You will love it, your speakers will love it, your headphones will love it, your ears will love it. I'm going back to the guest musicians because I wasn't quite finished there. I have to mention a couple of others, and I'm not going to mention names because, well, that would be too much to mention. You just have to look up, you know, the credits on the album to see who has all been involved in it. The additions that these guest musicians bring, the string instruments, the brass instruments, the wind instruments, you know, put them all next to the, well, instruments and people I already mentioned, and well, you can guess the result, you know, it all adds to this flavor, it all adds to this storytelling of these tales of people and places, and they really transport you there. It's really stunning what they do. There are fantastic guitar solos by Dave Gregory. I really enjoy them very much. That there's the drumming, Nick DeVirgilio. I mentioned him, that he was great, but he really stands out on this album by the fact that sometimes you don't even notice he's there. And that's good. That's what I like about it, because especially in an album like this and music like this, no instrument should dominate, you know? They should all be in balance, in harmony with each other. And they are here. Really fantastic. Beautiful keyboard solos. Did I mention the vocals? Of course I mentioned them. I absolutely am a big fan of David Longden. He has a fantastic voice. I love to listen to him singing. But it's not just his vocals, his lead vocals that bring the magic. There are a lot of beautiful multi-layered harmonies on this album as well. And again, you know, it adds to the fullness and the richness of the music. I gotta say, if you are familiar with Big Big Train, if you were really impressed by the Unafold Yard, you will be blown away by English Electric Part 1. You will absolutely be blown away. And the great thing is, the fun, the enjoyment doesn't end with this album, because as I mentioned a couple of times, Part 1. The band is going to release a part 2. As a matter of fact, I am rather late with my review. My apologies for that. I kind of didn't realize what kind of a gem I had in my hands, because this one was released in September 2012. March 2013, the band will release English Electric Part 2. And trust me, if it carries on the line set in this album, well, you will love it. It will be such a huge treat. Of course, there's much more to discover. I mean, this album is like a really good book. A good book that when you're finished reading, you can read again and still find new things. But even, you know, if you don't find new things, you still enjoy re-reading the story, re-listening this album, re-living the tales they tell on this album. Really fantastic. And if you listen to it, please do that with headphones. Trust me, if you haven't done it, you will thank me for it, because when you do that, the music will absolutely transport you to another world. I gotta be honest, it did to me. When I was listening to the album with my headphones, it kind of brought me back, well, not too far ago, but a couple of years back, summer 2010, when I had, well, the actual privilege and pleasure to be in the English countryside, to be in this rustic, cozy pub somewhere in the middle of nowhere, listening to the beautiful music on English Electric. I really see myself sitting there, enjoying the sun, enjoying this lovely pint of proper job. My advice to you is very simple. Buy this album. And you can buy it on CD, and you can see it's very beautiful. You can buy it on even more beautiful vinyl. You have bigger artwork, and, well, maybe even a little richer audio mix. But you can also, if that's your cup of tea, buy a legal download. But whatever you do, buy this album, because no music collection will ever be complete without Big Big Train's English Electric Part 1.